सो हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम। वील स्टार्ट विद द क्लास 8 साइंस, द सेकेंड चैप्टर, दैट इज माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, फ्रेंड्स एंड फोर्स, वेयर वी वुड टॉक अबाउट द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स, और सिंपली वी कॉल देम एज माइक्रोब्स। व्हाट डू वी कॉल देम? वी कॉल देम एज माइक्रोब्स। ओके, सो व्हाट आर द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स? सो लेट्स सी, I put some dots here. So right now you can see these dots. Visible to you? Yes, dots are visible to you. Now if I put a very, very small dot here, I think one dot which I have put here is not visible to you. Even it is not visible to me from here also. So how would I see this one dot? So I would need a magnifying glass to see it. Yes or not? I would need a magnifying glass to see this one dot. So similarly, there are some organisms or some micro means very small organisms. You must be knowing, we, I am organisms, you are organisms, plants are coming under organism, anything. Okay, all are coming under the organism, animals are coming under the organism. Micro means very small. So very small organisms we are going to talk here. Okay, so there are in our nature, there are very, very small organisms also which we cannot see through, or which you cannot see by unaided eyes. We need some kind of help or some kind of aid to see those organisms. So such organism will be called the microorganisms or also microbes. Okay, so let me write here about the microorganisms. Organisms that cannot be seen by unaided eye unaided eyes or we need some kind of help to see them are called microbes or microorganisms. Okay, so means some organisms are very small, but you can see those organisms by using a magnifying glass. If I put their magnifying glass, yes, we can see those organisms. But still there are very, very small organisms also. For such organisms, we need a special kind of instrument called microscope. Okay, so for them, we need microscopes to see them. Okay, so only with the help of microscopes, we can see them. So those are known as the microorganisms. Okay, so we can classify the microorganisms into four categories. Microorganisms can be classified into four categories. Here I am writing microorganisms can be classified into four categories. Can be classified into four categories basically. So first one is algae, second one fungi, visible, yeah, third one you have their bacteria, and the fourth one is protozoa. Now one more category of microorganisms you have here which are different from all these four, that is virus. One more category is there, that is virus. Why we are putting them in some certain other categories? The reason is that the virus needs some other organisms to live in. Means, suppose let's say a virus here. So this virus is dead here. Okay, it cannot live on its own. Rather, it needs some other bacteria or it needs some other organisms to live in. So, okay, so virus will live inside some other organisms. It can survive in some other organisms, or it can multiply, it can be multiplied there inside some other organisms. Okay, so on its own, the virus has not, means it is dead at that time. But when it enters into someone other's body, then it can survive there inside and it can multiply there also on its own. Okay, so these are the virus. So this is how we have these four categories and one special category, that is virus. Virus is very different from these four. How it is different? Because it needs some other organisms to live in. Okay, it needs, or I'm writing here, virus needs some other organisms to live in. On its own, it does not have any life. On its own, the virus does not have any life. But as soon as it enters into someone other's body, and that time it just survived there and multiply also on its own. One virus going inside and multiplying into many other viruses. Okay, so this is the basic difference between these four category of microorganism and the virus. Okay, so now we would be discussing about these all things in detail, like algae, fungi, bacteria, protozoa, and the virus. Okay, so write this off and let me erase this now. So the first one is algae. So if you see algae, now let me tell you one thing. Like we are organism, we are also organism, animals are also organisms, but we are multicellular, rather we have many cells inside. Okay, millions and trillions of cells are there inside our, and with the help of these trillions of cells we are made. So we are multicellular organisms. Okay, and but some are unicellular organisms, means in them only one cell will be there. They are known as the unicellular organisms. They are made up of only one cell, single cell. And some are made up of two or three cells. They are also multicellular organism, but the quantity of cell is very low there in that case. Okay, but we have trillions of cells. We are made up of trillions of cells. Are you getting this? But some organisms are there which have only one cell, known as the unicellular organisms. Some organisms are there which have more than two or three cells, known as multicellular organisms. We are also multicellular organisms. Some other organisms are also there which are multicellular organisms. But some are there unicellular also, means made up of only single cell. So here if I talk about these algae, so algae are also, can be also multicellular also, and in certain cases these algae are unicellular also. Okay, in some cases algae are multicellular, but in some cases these are unicellular also. Okay, so I can add, algae can be multicellular or can be unicellular also. Algae can be multicellular and unicellular also. Okay, these are algae. Okay, about algae I have told you there in the previous class. Next one, that is fungi. So what is this fungus? So if you have a bread and keep this bread out for 4 or 5 days, दिस इज द पीस ऑफ ब्रेड, कीप दिस पीस ऑफ ब्रेड आउटसाइड फोर और फाइव डेज, एंड देन आफ्टर फोर और फाइव डेज यू वुड सी सम ग्रीन काइंड ऑफ ग्रोथ ओवर दिस ब्रेड, दिस इज द ग्रीन ग्रोथ ओवर द ब्रेड. सो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड द फंगस, वी कॉल इट फंगस. ओके, और इन द प्रीवियस क्लास, प्रीवियस वीडियो आई हैव टोल्ड यू राइजोपस, स्पेशल टाइप ऑफ फंगस राइजोपस. ओके, सो दिस इज फंगस. ओके, सो दिस फंगस इज ऑल्सो मल्टी सेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. सो दिस फंक्शन इज फंगस इज ऑल्सो एन ऑर्गेनिज्म बट इट्स अ मल्टी सेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिज्म. ओके, एंड द ग्रीन ग्रोथ ओवर द ब्रेड इज कॉल्ड द फंगस. ओके, हियर आई एम राइटिंग फंगस इज द ग्रीन ग्रोथ ओवर द पीस ऑफ ब्रेड. इट कैन बी सॉरी दे आर मल्टी सेल्युलर इन नेचर. मल्टी सेल्युलर इन नेचर. नाउ द थर्ड वन अबाउट विच वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक इज द व्हाट इज दिस बैक्टीरिया. बैक्टीरिया. नाउ बैक्टीरिया, दीज बैक्टीरियाज आर बेसिकली दीज आर यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स. दीज आर यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स मीन्स यू कैन नॉट सी देम. यू कैन नॉट सी देम, यू नीड सम काइंड ऑफ एड टू सी देम. ओके, सो दैट इज वाई दे आर यूनिसेल्युलर ऑर्गेनिजम्स. ओके, now we have some ailments or some diseases which are caused by the bacteria, and the diseases are like we have tuberculosis, like we have typhoid. So these are the diseases which are caused by bacteria, and the diseases, right, I'm writing here, and the diseases that are caused by bacteria are, what are those diseases, are typhoid and tuberculosis. Okay, so these are the two diseases which are caused by bacteria. Now we have the fourth category of the microorganisms, that are protozoa. So protozoa, these are also the single celled or also the unicellular organisms. These are unicellular organisms. Okay, and we have some diseases which are caused by the protozoa, like malaria, like dysentery. So these are some diseases which are caused by protozoa, and the diseases that are caused by protozoa are, what are those diseases, like what I said, malaria or dysentery. Malaria, or you have dysentery, etc. So these are some diseases which are caused by protozoa. Okay, so these were the four categories of microorganisms. Now we will be talking about the fifth one, special category, that is the category of virus. Very what can say, harmful also nowadays, coronavirus. You must be knowing about the corona. So it's a coronavirus. So COVID-19, this is the disease name which is caused by this coronavirus. So it's also a virus. Okay, so what is this virus? When it enters into someone's body, inside our or inside someone else's body, so it multiplies, it survives there, and it multiplies, gets multiplying there, keep multiplying there. Okay, so and causing a big damage to our lungs. Okay, so that is about the coronavirus. Okay, so let's study about the virus today. That is the fifth category of microorganisms. Virus. So what are the virus? So virus, if you see, virus, they require some a living body or the host to live in. They require a living host to live in, to survive. Okay, and due to virus, again we have some diseases which are caused by the virus. And diseases that are caused by the virus are like we have some common cold, like cold. This cold is caused by virus. Like we have influenza. This is again caused by virus. Very good example, like polio. This polio is also a disease which now just considered to be eradicated under the Pulse Polio program. Okay, but still this is a disease which was caused by the polio virus. Okay, and now it is being vaccinated. Okay, now we have one more disease, that is chickenpox also. So these are some diseases which are caused by the virus. Okay, so this is all about for today. Now we would be discussing some new topics of this chapter, that is microorganisms, friend and foes, in the lectures ahead. Okay, now I would tell you, do subscribe to our channel, and if you have any suggestions or any comment, so please comment it in the comment box below. We will be happy to to eradicate those problems. Okay, then stay tuned, keep watching, see you in the next lecture.